Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. It's a painting of a floating city of Venice. It will not be easy for the beginners, but it will be very challenging. And please don't forget to subscribe. Yeah, please subscribe it and hit that bell button if you want to receive some future notification of my new videos and tutorials. Okay everyone, so you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there the 5 limited colors, the brushes and other things we're gonna need to paint the tutorial. Okay, so I'm going to proceed now. I'm not going to waste my time to paint this tutorial. Okay, so I'm going to paint today something like floating houses on Venice. Okay, so let's gonna do the first step first, which is the sketching. I'll do a little sketch first before we're gonna start, and I'll be using this raw umber and white. I'm mixing it with white so that it will become lighter and it will be easy for me to mix with other colors. Okay, and I found the photo from the Pixabay, but I'm going to change it. I'm going to change everything what I see there. Okay, so I am going to put some horizon here. Yeah, this will be my horizon. House is here. This will be the perspective, everyone. It will not be so easy. There's a lot of details, plenty of details. Okay, someone is calling me. I should be a little careful for this one. Because it's not so easy, everyone. Yeah, just doing the sketch, it's a little hard. You know, because I need to make sure that perspective is good. Yeah, I think I'll move a little this one here. So it will look like this. I think there's the point is here. So there's an imaginary line here that directly to the horizon. So it's the perspective should work like that. But maybe later soon I will show you how to properly make it. But this one I just use my eyes where I'm gonna put these things. And also I'm copying up from a photo, so I'll just do my best to make it look better. There's plenty of details here, but I will change everyone. I will change something. I want to be look more original on my. I want it to be look more original when I produce it. So, and I think I will just make it a little more impressionistic because I think I have no time to make it as detailed as possible. Impressionism, everyone, it will also make it detailed, but. But you can see that the some parts there, like the strokes. Okay. Some details, tiny details here. Plenty of details to play. Okay, yeah. So, really sketching will take time because this one will be a little. Maybe I'll just make the sketching. In time lapse mode. Okay. Okay, so I'll just cut a little and yeah, I think I'm done. Okay, so I think I'm done with my sketching and I'm gonna proceed now to the blocking of colors. Okay, I'll just be using a bigger brush, virtual flat brush, and I'm going to make the sky a little more orange. Yeah. So here, yellow and red and white. Yeah, I like to play it with some. Maybe I'll just try to make the. Canvas a little wet first. So that it will be easy for me to create those strokes. Also know when canvas is a little dry, it will be hard for us to create those things to drag our brush into the canvas. See, you can also wet your canvas so that just like what the colors we want, it will be easy to use the brush. Okay, so I have here the red. I'm going to add some white to make it pink. Yeah, I'm gonna add some white and yellow. And then I'll be using some blue and red. And white. To make it purple. Yeah. A little white. There, I love the sky, so clean. Yeah, maybe we can just add more later in the sky. Yeah. I will be using a smaller brush. It's number 8 flat brush, and I'm gonna start adding some colors there. Yeah, first I'm gonna use this raw umber with white. I will create first some shadows. Yeah, I like to add these shadows here, even though my reference has no shadow, but I like to add some shadows because, you know, I want active sunlight. So this part here, I'm gonna put some shadow. Then a little lighter, this one, I think I like to put some shadow here. And also this one. Okay. Then I will try this one. Maybe I'm gonna do it this way, like that. I like to make this part, it's okay, it's fine. hair. The other one, maybe this one, I want it to just dark. Yeah, I want this building to be dark. And also this one here. Okay. There. So you can just put some wet raw umber there. This will also cover some. This also covers some white white things from the background, especially the canvas. Yeah, this is what we call that underpainting. Okay, I think this will take some time, everyone. It's been 18 minutes and I'm still doing this. Yeah, maybe I'll just use a bigger brush. Yeah, I think this one is fast, will be faster. And also for the water, I think I'll just put something like this. There. Okay. Now I'll start adding details here on the farther part. Yeah, this one here. So I'll be using more yellowish yellow and red. Yeah, a little more orange. should be, I want it to be more orange or something, more yellowish. And also this one. And then the other one on the back. There. It can be lighter also, you can also use the light color. And then I'll be using this raw umber. I want to create a darker color here. There. Yeah, and then I think it's time to use a smaller brush for further details. I'm gonna go closer. I'll just use this raw umber, everyone. And some lighter brown. There. And also the roof, something like an orange roof. The roof can be something like an orange. Okay. And then I will try to put smaller details like the windows. I'll be using also this raw umber, a little white. Yeah, it's gonna put some windows. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, you can just put some random windows there. Now I'll put some blue green windows. Okay, another windows here. So you can use a smaller brush if you have. There. Okay. Can I see there, everyone? Now I'll try to put some more tiny details through umber. Yeah, I'll use a smaller brush. This will create the tinier details. Just have to put a little more detail just to create some more details here for these buildings, and then we'll proceed here. I'll try to put more solid colors. Red and yellow, yeah. It will be much more like pink. I'll add more white. The other one will be a little darker. Okay. I'll try to create a little darker colors. And this one here, some orange on the top, on the. I want it to be more reddish. Okay. Another pink here. There. I'm going to use a bigger brush. I'm going to mix for more reddish and yellow. Put some roof here, but I'll just make it dark. There. Okay, now I'll try to use blue umber, red, and yellow. This part will be dark, everyone. I want it to be dark. And also here. Something like a gate here. And then also here. And in here is some dark tan on the bottom. Yeah. There. I'm gonna do it a little slowly, everyone, because this is not so easy. That's it. door here. There's another door here, a window, I mean. Yeah, it's not so straight, everyone, but it's fine. There. This is, it'll be a little more impressionistic. And it should always be in perspective, everyone. Okay, yeah, that looks good. And then the other one here. Some kind of big window here. Okay. Yeah, it's really a slow process, everyone, so okay, so I think I'll try to put the water now. Oh yeah, maybe I'll still need to put some few details here. Yeah, it should be in a proper perspective, everyone. So I. Yeah, I will put some more bluish color there. So that the color will become off or dark. Just throw umber and blue, and we're gonna make these sides dark. Yeah, I'll just make these sides dark. Because the light's coming from here, and of course, it will cover some parts there. And then you're gonna put the windows like that. Ah, I'll put some details there, but I'll just make it like there's some not so clean to look. Yeah, I'll just make this part dark, because I don't want any light striking this part here. So I just want this one dark. Yeah. Okay. And then I'm going to make some more darker reddish color on this part here. I'll just make a little dark, dark brown or something. And then I'm gonna darken these windows here using raw umber and blue. Yeah, it will become more impressionistic, everyone. Okay, so I'll try to put some color, some dark greens or bluish color on the water. So here I have some blue, yellow and red. I do not like this brush. I'll be using a bigger brush. So just create the downward strokes, everyone. Okay, so here. Just upgrade the reflections, but I will also do the reflections from here on the. And put some yellow. Just copy the yellowish sky there and put it here. I'll try to use this purple here. There. So we're just following anything we can see there at the top. And put it down there. You can also use bigger brush, everyone, if you are having a hard time using this brush. Okay. So I think I'll just take a rest for a little while. Okay, everyone, so I'm going to continue. So for as of now, I'm done with the most of the underpainting, so I'm going to start adding some thick strokes. So I'm going to do my best to create thick strokes on this. It will be more like impressionistic, so I want to look that way. And yeah, I'm going to do it now, and I'm gonna make this a very good yellow sunrise, or yeah, something like that on the background. Yeah, okay. I'm using number 8 flat brush. And here I have the red and white. I'm gonna make it pink. Yeah, I just want to make it impressionistic. With thick paints. You're gonna put some more yellow. I just want to make an orange sky, everyone. So there. I think this canvas is too rough, I think, yeah. Okay, I have some purple and then white. Okay. Yeah, I'll try to use this more orange color. Put it here. Sometimes I don't like this canvas because, yeah, maybe I need to put one more coat for the prime because it's very, very hard. It's a problem with the some of the canvas, it doesn't put a good amount of Then I will add more yellow here. Okay, and then some orange. Thank you. you can just create two zigzag strokes around. You can also try to use this white here. Okay, and then I will try to mix some more, a little gray, yes, or bluish gray, something like that. Yeah, it will be a little more light. And also this one. I'll just copy what I see in the top and then put it down. And then I'll use some pink. And I'll try to make this thicker. Okay. There. And I also try to put some reflections here. So it will be here. And then I'll try to make some darker reflections, blue and the raw umber. Just create the these horizontal dark colors, everyone, like this. Yeah, sorry everyone, if my background is really noisy, there are children playing outside. There. Okay. And now I'll use this yellow, light orange with white. There. I'll just try to put some reflections here. So just a small horizontal strokes like this one. There. Okay. And then this one here. Okay, and I will add more. I think I will add more color of the sky, so it will be more purple, blue, and red, and white. There. Okay. Yeah, that looks more realistic, everyone. Yeah, I will try to put some more greens or darks. I want it to be there are plenty of darks there, but I will also put some more highlights. So another lighter color. Just to put a little highlight there, just to make this part look more realistic. Okay. I use some white to, and using this liner brush, I can create more tinier details like this white here. And just use the plain white. Runners are here. Can just put more tinier details there. Just to make it look like there's plenty of details. Even just the same with the okay. Okay. Yeah. I'll just put more details, everyone. It's very important to make it look more good, realistic. I'll be using a smaller brush. This one. I'll try to put some tree here. There's a tree growing on this part, on this back of the house. Also here. I'll just put some solid dark. Thank you. I'll put a little lighter, so raw umber and white, and a little blue. Look like more impressionistic, everyone. But I like about impressionistic because you don't need to make it perfectly good to follow those things to see there. That's a good thing about impressionism. Try to use orange again for some roof, okay. I want it to be a little dark. Okay. So far it looks good. Yeah, but I want to darken this part here. Yeah, I just don't want to see those things there. I'll put some more bluish tone here. And of course here, but I'm gonna make some tiny patches of blue color. And then I'll try to use this red and white. Create some a little reflection there from this building there. Okay. I'll use more white. I'll just put some details that there are some buildings also there on the back part. Okay, so I want more dark, I want darker. Okay. Yeah, maybe this part here, but I will make it darker. Yeah, I just use this dark color here. Yeah, I'm thinking what else could I could add more. Yeah, maybe I will just put yeah, I think I'll just put some more background clouds. Yeah. Put some more lighter clouds there on the background. So I'll just use the yellow and the white. There. Just use another brush because a little dirty. Okay, I will continue adding more dark tones there, here and here also. Try to use some purple with white. And also on the other side, I want it to be more bluish. Just try to put them dark tones to you. Okay, I think it looks good, everyone. Yeah. Yeah, I think I like the colors. Now it looks it focuses here on the center. Yeah, and it's so dark here. Actually, it's not so clean. The paint is not so clean, so I might need to put more clean. Make it more clean. Especially the strokes, but I like the result because it's very impressionistic. So you can see the strokes there, you can see that it's impressionism. Yeah, and also I like the lights I composed there, because in the photo it was not like this, so I just changed everything there to make it look this way. Yeah, maybe I will put a boat there. Yeah, I don't know what. Maybe I'll just put up one boat and I am done. Yeah, maybe I'll just retouch. Yeah, I'll just do more retouch and I think I'm done, everyone. Okay, so I think I'll just do some more retouch, everyone, and I think I'm done. Yeah. Now it's 1 hour, I think it's almost 1 hour and 30 minutes. So I'll just retouch and sort of time. I'll be using the liner brush. So here. Okay. I'll just put more orange. For this part here. There. Okay. So I think I'm going to put some, yeah, I think it looks good. I'm thinking about a boat, everyone, but I'm not sure if it will give some justice here. Yeah, but yeah, maybe I'll just put some boat here and I think I'm done. I don't know what it will be look like, but yeah, maybe here. I'll make it a little bluish. Reflections like this. Yeah, and there's a little highlights. And then some people there. Since that part will be dark, so I just do that way. Okay. Yeah, okay everyone, so yeah, I think that will be all. I think this is just a pretty easy tutorial. And if you want to paint this one, so you are free to paint this one. It will not be so hard, just a little complicated because it's kinda a little different, and yeah, it will be very challenging for you, especially for the beginner. So good luck everyone, and thank you for watching this video today. This is not my typical style because I'm using now here impressionistic. Okay
everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.